Peyton's playing Kylie. Not.
Yeah, I guess the invent.
5 seconds left. They got to shoot it. Kylie, shot. Wow, that was huge.
What a great shot.
Talk about a big-time player coming through to key time. There's the NBA three right there. I mean, she was about 3 or 4 feet away from the three-point line. Kylie O'Donnell has just come up with big basket after big three-point basket after in this game, and there's none bigger than this one right here.
Swished it.
With Peyton in her face providing some pressure. I mean, it was a semi-open three, but Peyton was providing some pressure. And there's no bigger shot right there. Here we see them looking at O'Donnell. And again, Peyton was playing off of O'Donnell a little bit more than I thought. She got to her as she took the shot up, but initially she was playing off of her. If you look at her angle right here. But then she got to put a little bit of pressure. But boy, what a huge shot right there. Probably the biggest of her career.
Probably going to do the same thing they just did.
And again, you're only down by two right now, so.
Off. Game over. Sterling's season's going to be over.
That's it.
I think the biggest thing was it was kind of a shocker to us. I remember saying that it was supposed to be our year. We really thought that we had the best shot to win Group 2. And we knew it was going to be a tough game, but we figured at home we were playing good basketball, you know. We could take care of business, and I think that was just kind of a heartbreak.
What I learned, and hopefully what they learned, is that we need to make the game. We need to make the other team play the way we want them to play. I think in the Camden game, we got off too fast to playing that really, really up-tempo style of basketball, which we can do. But against teams that thrive off of that, we need to force them to play a more slow, methodical, tough, and physical game.
That was a tough loss. We kept our heads up. We played our best. There's nothing really could do about it. It was a game that we knew that we could win, but unfortunately.
It was heartbreaking. I would say disappointing, because I don't think you ever go into a game thinking you would lose and like that. But it was a really good game, honestly.
After that game, there just wasn't anything to say. You know, the girl made an awesome three. Kylie made an awesome three to get us into overtime. And, after that game, it was just, everything got sucked out of us. The next days at school, we're all wearing sweatpants, and we just don't want to repeat of that at all.
Me and Tyra, I know we took it just as hard as they did, cried just as much. But Kylie and all the juniors were there to tell us to help us get through it and tell us not to worry about it because they're so.
Of course, it was hurtful. I mean, this was the moment we were waiting for, and this was a big game that we all knew was going to happen. But I think we knew that we left it on the floor.
The Lady Knights girls basketball season ended in an upset to Camden. The soon-to-be senior girls now had 1 year to make their mark at Sterling and in the girls basketball community. The team would open the season as the number one team in South Jersey. Here is a look at their journey in the 2010-2011 season and their one shining moment.
Yeah, you know what it is. Everything I do it big. Yeah, there's nothing. When I take a jump shot, that's something. Repping my team. When you see me, you know everything. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver. I hold it down for my team. You know what I mean. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver.
blue and silver, you can see the name. Sterling Knights, we the best, come check the game. Check the refs later, forget the spectators. You know where we going, coast to coast, we take it home. If you tripping, we gon' let you get the tip off. By the end of it all, your team gon' be pissed off. Check the record board, check the stat sheet, check the scoreboard, we some athletes. And we running at a fast pace, they yelling go get them. So we run a fast break, we take it to the bank. They looking at us though, she went from 999 to 1000. Yeah, you know what it is. Everything I do it big. Yeah, that's nothing. When I take a jump shot, that's something. Reppin' my team, when you see me, you know where it is. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver. I hold it down for my team, you know what I mean. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver. Lady Knights grabbing the ball, ripping it off the backboard. Taking them downtown to town, pulling all them rebounds. You already know what it is. Blue and silver girls, they handle the biz. If you tryna play bit of practice, well, they got the blue and silver, blue and silver. Fast break, down the court. People is a game, find another sport. Every time we step on the floor, we sweeping you off. Look at the score. Dedication, patiently waiting for the time we rise up. We taking it all. Lady Knights, call us the champions. Yeah, you know what it is. Everything I do it big. Yeah, that's nothing. When I take a jump shot, that's something. Reppin' my team, when you see me, you know where it is. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver. I hold it down for my team, you know what I mean. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver. Blue stripes, face paint on my eyes too. So when I look up, all I see is light blue. Ha ha, what a disgrace, slapping in your face. Call yourself competition, this ain't even a race. Especially you on a fast break. I guess the championship ring is coming our way. Hey, long overdue, if you went away we running through. Cause we be the Lady Knights, aka the champions. Yeah, you know what it is. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver. Yeah, you know what it is. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver. I hold it down for my team, you know what I mean. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver. I hold it down for my team, you know what I mean. Blue and silver, blue and silver, blue and silver.
Summer practices were a big success. It was every Tuesday and Thursday, so we're getting there twice a week. And our roles, me as well as the other seniors, was kind of set the example. I think Nisa and Tyra were freshmen. You had Erica, Gwen, Dylan, and that crew, juniors. And then you had some of the other freshmen from the freshman team coming once in a while. And I think it was just kind of our role was to set the tone, to say that, you know, we think this is our year, but it's not just us. Like, it has to permeate down to them because they're as big a part of the team as we are. And I think we just kind of wanted to show them, like, you know, this is the intensity we're bringing into it. And I think that it actually went over really well because we worked on a lot of things in the summer where it was kind of like, we're going to carry this right into the start of the season in the fall. So I think that really actually helped us prepare for this year.
It was tough, actually. K-Head is in there working hard. Well, she wasn't the coaches, but, you know. It went well, though, seeing, like, what everyone was capable of doing this year. Like, for me, instance, shooting the ball more, or Kylie driving to basket and dribbling. Tanjay Hodge rebounding. Everyone did good this year. It was tough, though. We all, like, kicked each other's butts.
Previous years, during the summer, you know, we goof around, we didn't run, we didn't do 5-4-3-2-1s, we didn't do all the games, but this year was, you serious? We got in. We did running. We did conditioning. You know, we got a lot of reps in. And this year's summer was great, especially with the summer league. You know, we went undefeated. If there was a championship game, I think we would have been against Gloucester Catholic. They went undefeated, and it would have, you know, a great way to start the season. You want to win championships, and little things like summer league, fall leagues, you know, even the Delsey tournament, all the way up. You know, it just each championship is important. And this summer, we worked our hardest to be the best that we are and to deserve that number one title this year. And it all starts in the summer when you work hard.
Summer went extremely well. Of all the summers that I've been here, this past summer was probably the best all around. It was a summer where we actually came in and put in work, as opposed to coming around and shooting. And every player was there every Tuesday and Thursday, if you could make it. And it was also very fun. Like, we always have a good time, which is good because it's summer too, but we all came ready to work. It was good.
This was my first summer practice because, as you guys know, I was a transfer. But it was kind of new to me. Like, I'd never been to a summer practice with Sterling, and I didn't really know what to expect this year. But I knew it would be fun because I know the girls and Kate, they always make it fun when we're around, well, when we're together. But I think we definitely improved as a team. Our chemistry got better, we got stronger, mentally prepared. We knew what we needed to do. We knew what was at stake. And I think they definitely helped, as well as summer league too.
Summer practices weren't meant to be just fun. Kate wanted you to have fun, but she wanted you to take it just as serious as regular season, which we did. We took the time and we came in and we worked hard and we did everything we were supposed to, and then we put that work into summer league games.
Summer practice, the motivation came from the Camden loss at the end of the year. And the night that we lost, the girls texted me and said, we are ready to do whatever it takes to get better, to win a championship. So summer practices were very intense, very well attended. Everybody was there, everybody came and worked really, really hard. And the biggest compliment that I got was the girls telling me that it felt just like a regular season practice.
Yeah. basketball?
Name, grade, phone number, birthday.
Wait.
Name, grade, phone number, birthday.
She's playing, Kai, that's for real.
Yeah.
I'm upstairs. Don't she know? She got my address.
Name, grade, birthday.
1693. I forgot my work. Hi, Kate.
Yeah, my job number.
She sent my email. I give you all my
active
tag.
All right, Kylie's coming.
If you haven't, just hold it up.
Goals for the team are to take things one step at a time. I think that there are so many expectations, and the girls have championship in their head, but we have to win one thing at a time. We have to win our Christmas tournament. We have to win the SJIBT. We want to win the conference. Then we want to win Group 2. Those are our major goals, to win those championships. I think the ultimate goal of the season is to win Group 2. And then anything after that, I mean, I'd be lying to you if myself and the girls didn't think that there was a possibility that we could win a state championship. I definitely think that's a possibility, but we can't look past the little championships that we have to do.
They were all like quiet and all cuddled and bundled up. I'm sure everyone was tired and probably still full from Thanksgiving dinner. But they were all just like on the sidelines. And I was just like, come on, like get up, get ready, get pumped. We're about to practice. Like season's starting. Wake up, be a little alive. And I brought everybody in the middle to wake everyone up. And it was kind of cold, so I thought maybe we should stretch and start get things moving.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
First 2 days of practice went way better than I expected. There were about 10 less people that came than I thought, so just having the lower numbers was helpful. But the coolest thing was Friday morning, 8 o'clock practice, day after Thanksgiving. Everybody's usually putting on the shoes and still sleepy. I walked in, quarter of. Everybody's in the circle, stretching, counting, clapping, talking, music was on. And I literally walked in the gym and got goosebumps and smiled because I knew looking at that moment right there that those girls were ready to practice. And both practices were sharp, they were focused, they were upbeat. I think this year was different for a couple reasons. I think the seniors are super, super motivated, and I felt like they just brought a ton of energy. They knew what was expected of them, and you know, if you have good leaders, you also have to have good followers, and the leaders led and the followers followed.
I think they went pretty well. I think we started the season off pretty crisp, and it was good. And obviously, you're going to be a little rusty the first couple days of practice. We were in the old gym because the floors were getting done, so it was smaller. But we had those workouts leading up to the first practice and the first week of practice. And I think that helped a lot because a lot of the people that were freshmen last year and going to be freshmen kind of saw what we expected going into the first couple days.
So make sure that you guys are talking to get on everybody. If they're dropping pants, if they're being sloppy, yell at them, tell them to respect the level. But at the same time, you got to try to encourage people. You know, like things like 3-on-2, 2-on-1, I want you guys in the front so you're working together. And then when you get to the back line, keep trying to explain to everybody what they should be doing. You guys aren't trying out, obviously. But you guys don't have to worry about that. What? You guys have to work hard and take the turn for them and push each other because you guys, today can't be a waste of time for you guys. It has to be intense. Everything has to be done today. Alright? Have fun.
The list. First practice of this year. Very simple, very basic. Lots of running.
I think we did our most running ever, especially because we're in the small gym. The small gym isn't, you know, the best place to do things. We did sidelines. And the worst thing for me personally is first practice, Timmy Mack always picks someone to run with. And when you run with Timmy Mack, you run the fastest. You are in front of everybody.
I almost died. I'm not even gonna lie. I almost died at practice. I was not ready for it at all. We did a lot of running and stuff, but it went well, though, to see, like, the varsity team back together.
At first, I think it started a little rough, but eventually we got it together. And from then, we've just been rolling, just doing good.
No, they were rough. Everybody was just getting back from their own sports. They knew how much running was in store, but once it actually came and hit us, we thought we were ready, and we really weren't.
Remember when Mr. K he mic'd the coaches to, like, when you guys were talking to us, but then so we both listened to it in the crisis, so we ended that whole thing.
See, I have a better voice than you.
Just, I'm just remembering
the first thing that runs through your head is, like, I can't get hurt. I don't want to miss however many weeks it takes for a broken ankle. And it was just one of those things where it hurt right away, and I was just trying to think positive, but I was thinking, like, I don't want to be hurt. This is my senior year. I'm not the type of person that likes that everybody right around me like that. And I told TJ that. She's like, well, what do you expect? Like, you have to take a moment to realize, like, that how special that is. I was crying and laughing because I was hurt. And then I was thinking about the worst when I shouldn't have been. And then I just thought about it. And I was just like, I'm glad I had them there after that all, because they made me laugh. And watching the video of it afterwards was pretty comical. But that's what it makes you realize, just how lucky you really are to have that, because, you know, that's what makes our team different from everybody else.
I hope you carry on, for it won't be long.
Okay,
it's
so great.
Somebody to leave out. You just call.
Get down, my jaw went down when she went down. I didn't know. All I could think was, big game Monday is our opener game. She's gonna score 1,000th point, and could this potentially mean she's not going to be able to play? Would she not score 1,000th point? And I've seen Kylie go down before, and when she went down in that practice, it was, in my opinion, one of the worst times she's gone down. She cried. She screamed, and she was just, you could tell she was in excruciating pain. And it was just like, and you also kind of feel like helpless because you can't do anything to help her. I would prefer if it didn't happen to anyone, but if it had to have happened, I would rather it happened to me instead of her, you know? But in Sean's office, my whole thing in Sean's office was, I was trying to keep her, like, level-headed and sane. I didn't want her to overthink anything, because I knew she thought she broke her ankle. She thought she would be out for the rest of the season. She didn't think she would ever step on the floor again. And I think when you get hurt, you automatically assume those kind of things. But I wanted to keep her, like, Kai, like, mental, in a good mental state, and cheer her up, of course.
Didn't want her to get hurt because it was her senior year. I knew she had hurt her ankle really bad because I never seen Kai like that. I was just hoping that she was all right.
First thing that popped in her head is championships, her season, that 1,000 point, you know, who do we have to replace her? Are we going to be able to keep up with our bench? You know, all those things rush through your head. And when someone gets hurt, Kate usually has, you know, some kind of mental set where she freaks out, or she was so calm. She was like, you know, we can do this, ladies. We've done it before. You know, you just got to keep practicing, got to work through the trials, and that's what it was. She was fine, she was calm, she knew Kylie would be okay, but the rest of us, something just got sucked out of us, that we just lost our momentum in practice, we just lost our wanting to play, as if we've, you know, losing Kylie is losing not only a part of your team, but a part of yourself, because she brings that emotional part to the game, she brings the heart to the game, she brings herself to the game. And, you know, when that happened, the practice was just like, kaput. It we all lost our drive to practice that game.
They're excited. They're almost a bit giddy. I tried to have this very serious speech and it was quiet, and then all of a sudden I just started cracking up. I was like, what's so funny about that? But they're excited. We had tried to make it a point not to hype up the game and the 1,000 points, which was a joke, because as soon as she touched the ball, it got like dead silent. Everyone's waiting for her to shoot.
The run to number one starts right now. Sterling wins the faceoff. Monica Birch bringing the ball up the court to Sanchez, down to Rachel Hodge. Back up to Kylie. She takes the shot, and it is off. Rebounded by Collingswood. Over to Tagland. She has her shot blocked. Here come the Knights. Over to Kylie. Foul, and it is off. Travel. Turnover. Like you said, probably those pregame jitters.
At some point, they're going to get the rhythm down here.
Sanchez with the ball. Kylie, open shot. It's off. Rebounded by Collingswood.
Well, I called a timeout after 2 minutes of nothing happening. I called a timeout just to kind of try to break the ice, because what I said to them in the timeout was, guys, I know you can't tune out the crowd, and I know you're excited, and I know this is a lot, but when Kylie shoots the ball, you can't all stand there and go like this and wait for something to happen. You have to get out there and box out and rebound and play, and it will all happen. And then once she hit the shot, obviously it was a great celebration for her, and I was so happy for her parents and everybody. Girls were happy.
It's over to Kylie. Back to Satchel, over to Birch. Cross court to O'Donnell. She takes the shot, and there it is! Number 1,000 for Kylie O'Donnell. The much-weighted shot, and it is finally in. As the team storms the court.
Fiddling on a three-pointer.
Congratulations, Kylie O'Donnell, the 17th player in Sterling history to reach the 1,000-point mark.
Yeah, and I mean, just the points don't even tell the story of the complete player that she is. I mean, she's a gritty player. She's a girl who dives all over the floor, and just a great accomplishment. I mean, she'll always have her name up there on that banner as being a 1,000-point scorer. And a great kid to go along with it. Of course, we know she's an outstanding student, ranked third in her class. There's her parents coming out. Obviously very supportive, coming to all the games.
Here's the replay. Kylie calling for the shot. She gets it, puts it up, and a three-pointer. It goes in, and she finally gets it. Congratulations to her. Here it is again. It was a cross-court pass, and she took it, and she swished it, just like all the other shots that she has.
Boy, that's the season opener, so right off the bat, it's nerves from the beginning. Like, I know, obviously, we played for 3 years before, but it doesn't matter. You still get the same feeling before every opening game. And just the fact that it was that on top of the opener, there's a lot of people there. You know, it's our first game. We're the number one team in South Jersey, and it was just, like, really antsy. And I think everyone was, like, expecting me to score right away, and then I missed a couple shots, and Kate, you know, just kind of said, you know, settle down, like, this is a normal game, just do the same things, and I think it kind of helped us just relax a little bit, and it was just like I was going to score when the time came.
I think she was nervous,
and she was trying to be careful because of her ankle. Before we even started, like when it was time for us to put her sneakers and everything on, she couldn't fit her sneaker, her foot into her sneaker.
Yeah, everyone was nervous. We were all talking about in the locker room, saying like, do you have butterflies and all this? Everyone's like, yeah. And this is the first game. Everyone wanted to get her 1,000 points away. So.
And it felt weird because the first quarter, you know, 1 minute passes, no score. Second minute passes, Collingswood scores. You know, third minute, Kylie's, you know, she's getting there. She keeps shooting. And you can hear if she misses a shot,
everybody was anxious. Everybody was anticipating it. But we didn't know when it was going to come. And we were hoping that first minute it was just going to be, like, there. But she kind of made us wait a while, which was okay.
And I think it's kind of cool because somebody like me that's a shooter and stuff doesn't just score the points, like, easy. You have to have, like, you have to get open. And then you have to have somebody like Monica that's going to get me the ball. Like, I'm always in a position to score because she always gets me the ball in a good place. And then I have, like, TJ and Rachel. Like, you saw in the Camden game, like, that shot doesn't happen if Rachel doesn't set that screen, like, get that second of air.
Once Kylie took care of her 1,000th point, the team cruised to a victory.
And there she goes, all alone. She takes the shot, and it's in. 2 points. Down low to Lewis. Back to O'Donnell, down to Sanchez. She saves it, takes the shot, and it's in. 2 points.
Yeah, again, real good ball movement right there.
Over to Satchel, down low to Lewis. Lewis with the shot, teardrop, and it's in.
Count.
Rachel Hodge back in the game, passes it down low to Satchel, and there it is. 2 points. First W of the season for Miss McDonald and the Sterling Lady Knights, 54-18.
I felt threatened by them just because I know what they play like, and they play very disruptive style. And I knew we were down a starter, which I had known for a while. And we had, you know, we had planned for that and everything. But just the fact that it was the first championship of the year, and one of the first goals of these girls was to win this championship. So it was, I guess I felt a little bit stressed out by the whole thing.
You know how they say, because we're number one, we have a target on our backs? I think Delsey was the first team to show us that we actually do really have a target on our backs. And kudos to them. They played well, they came ready to go, and they never gave up.
Very quickly, Sterling found out Delsey was ready to play. Kylie O'Donnell got the Lady Knights their first point. O'Donnell hit another three to give Sterling its first lead of the game. The first quarter ended with Sterling leading 11-9.
I just got to settle down on offense.
Delsey quickly got the lead back. The calls from the officials started to pile up.
Toward the right, the line is 1-1.
Yeah.
right of the line and shoot 1-1.
The first thing, to be honest, that was going through my head was that I can't believe that this is happening. I just couldn't believe the whole, it just seemed like anything that possibly could have gone wrong, went wrong. We got instantly in foul trouble. You know, Kylie's injured, and to the girls' credit, you know, when we were in timeouts and things like that, they kept their heads, they kept composed. We had three girls on the floor at one time that had never seen significant varsity playing time. And it was a really difficult, I almost felt bad that that was a spot that I had to put them in, because they didn't get, they just got thrown right into it. It was Erica, Dylan, and Gwen, and they just, it went off without a hitch. I mean, they battled, they fought, they maintained, which is what the subs, the bench is supposed to do, until we could get the starters back in.
And we went deep into our bench, and I'm looking at things at the one point in the game, and it's Dylan, Erica, Gwen, like, they're all on the court and contributing, where, you know, before we weren't able to do that, and now those girls can step in and do their jobs.
The game went back and forth to halftime. Delsey started the second half by increasing the lead. O'Donnell had another scary moment, but managed to stay in the game. Halfway through the third quarter, the Lady Knights got another scare.
Monica goes down and you're like, you know, this can't get any worse. TJ's in foul trouble. And
on the floor, at that point, I think everyone was worried about Monica. Whenever Monica goes down, everyone's always worried because we know she has bad ankles. But honestly, we all stayed composed and focused on what was going on in the game. Just because Monica was down didn't mean that we were down. We still had the lead and we still had control of the game.
Honestly, a lot of our plays rely on Monica. And when she went and got hurt, we knew that somebody would have to step up and be the leader. And we couldn't just rely on her all the time. We need to be a team and learn how to be dependent on each other and not just one person. And I think we really did that well as a team that day. She got hurt, and there was really wasn't anything we could do. I mean, we didn't want her to do it any more damage because we were going to need her later in the season.
No one knew the severity of the injury, but Monica was in the trainer's room trying to get herself back on the court. Yeah. With Monica in the locker room, the team did their best to stay in the game.
When you have to bear down through all those injuries, you have to protect the ball and take care of it. They're going to be all over you, all the pressure, and all those things.
I was saying that I needed to get back on the floor because I knew, like, my team knew that I wasn't going to go out like that. And I knew that we were losing too, so I couldn't let them down. And by being the leader, I knew I had to go back on the floor. Now, at first, when I first got hurt, I was laying on the ground and I was just thinking, like, I hope I didn't hurt it real bad. It wasn't as bad as I thought it was, walking on it and stuff, so I knew I was going to go back out there.
Down four with 22 seconds to go in the third quarter, Burks went back into the game.
All right, girls, 8 minutes left. Bearing down. Anytime you protect the ball, now would be a good time to do it, okay? Talk to the refs about the hand check, so just keep being strong on the ball. Keep them. effort up defensively, you're doing a much better job of watching that curl. You must box out and you must rebuild. You can't get any second chance shots. Offensively, you're only downfield, you don't have to rush it.
Starting the third quarter, Delsey increased the lead and the pressure on Sterling. Tanjay Lewis got the Lady Knights within four. A technical foul on the Delsey coach helped shift the momentum. Monica Burks made the Crusaders pay by making both of her free throws. The Lady Knights continued to take advantage and eventually got the lead back.
Gwen, you're actually a really nice person, and I appreciate how genuine you actually are. Do your answer machine rap.
Oh.
Do it.
Yo, it's G to the W, E, N. After the beat, you can begin. Just need your name and number, hit, and I'll try to get back if I can.
Yo, that's hot. Can you do mine?
Tell
Mr. K
what
chimp
it is.
Me?
Yeah.
I have no clue what it means. All I know is last year you made me say it because it was cold outside. So. Then we had a huge argument yesterday about what it really meant.
Yeah. So
there's two definitions.
Two different
things. It's two different things.
So I'm just going
to cold. Iris said it's three.
Iris said it's chip and cold?
Yeah, chip and cold. But
yeah. Come on, Wayne, you got to go out the screen.
I only did that one time.
Do it when she's in an argument. First day she says, Monica, you do it good.
Yeah, he's like, Tyra, yeah, the score was 50. No, it was. It was definitely 50, so don't we do that.
It was definitely 50. Like, I know it was 50. Yeah. Tanjay, you want to keep going, Tanjay. You always got to keep going.
Okay, T. T, who's the worst to argue with, Tyra or A?
They both gotta realize it, but Erica, it's ramen. Erica, we heard you. The first time. Repeating yourself like 24 times.
That worked with it. We talked about this in English today. Sometimes people are in relationships and they really do care about each other a lot. You guys really do love each other a lot. We treat each other very poorly. Then when you don't have the relationship anymore, you realize you didn't have it till it's gone. Like, you don't realize what you had till it's gone.
Okay, doctor.
Oh my god.
Really?
Dr. Kylie.
That was deep.
Yeah, Dr. Kylie, because she's always got me to one like,
until Kylie O'Donnell gets upset.
I know.
Then it's just a whole nother story.
No, I told you that.
I gripped Eric up the other day. I don't yell anymore.
You punched me in the stomach.
No, you yelled at me at practice.
Stomach in the game.
Like, what did I say?
You come,
come on.
Erica, let's go.
Kylie always tried to be so serious. Until, what was it? Until Monday. Until Monday, it was practice in the press. And Monica, like, did this nasty, like, clutch layup, right? Everybody went crazy. And then here she goes from Coach Carter. I tied that bow. And the whole gym died. Okay. Phil's not gonna think that's funny!
Get warmed up. Stars have had down to goes. What do you notice about the game plan?
3-point drive.
All 3-point drive. Okay, so make sure that you guys get out, protect that 3-point line. If you guys play defense the way you guys played against Hadfield, you're going to be absolutely fine. You have to protect the three, make them put the ball on the floor and do what they're not comfortable doing. You listen to all these different people, you got to do this, have towns, you got to do this against them. Forget that. You guys, they have to adjust to us. You guys go out there and do what you're supposed to do, and the game belongs to you. Number 22, Bossy, you're going to start on her. She is, you guys know Justice, she's 3-point threat. You got to make sure you guys contain her. She tends to drive to the left. If she gets by Bossy, make sure we step up. Everybody has to rotate over because they're very good at distance from the layup. So everybody make sure you rotate. Haji, you're going to start on Donaldson, number 20. She is a very scrappy player. Make sure you find her. Make sure you box her out. She has a lot of garbage around the basket, so don't lose her, but you got to help at the same time. T, you have number 13, Getzinger. She will also shoot the three. We talked about this yesterday. Make sure you keep a hand up. Make her put the ball on the floor. And she also tends to be a little bit dirty, so rough up a little bit. Anissa, you're going to start on Nicole, number 24. She's one of their ball handlers, also another 3-point shooter. She will drive. Just make sure the team keep your hand up. If you guys come out and they give you give them any breathing room, your hands are down, they're going to shoot. You always have to keep a hand up. And Kylie, you have Sink. She's another one of their best 3-point shooters. Make sure you keep her up. Make sure you contain her. Talked about the flex yesterday. Make sure you guys jump to the ball, fight through their screens, and as your girl's cutting, step up. He starts to cut, step up, give them a little shove. Bump them, knock them around, make them hurt them a little bit. You know, don't go crazy and foul out of the game, but shove them, push them, hit them. Don't nobody gets a free pass through that lane. Keys to winning are the same as they always are. Team defense. You guys have to play stifling team defense. Take them out of what they do. They will be very patient offensively and wait for a good shot. Kylie said this yesterday, if you guys play for 30 seconds and fall asleep for one, they're going to burn. You guys have to stay on your toes and play tough defense. Secondly, you must box out and do that. Do not let them get second chance shots. Your bread and butter as a team is rebounding and the fast break. You must box out, you must rebound, and everybody hits the offensive glass, especially you two, all over the rebounds. And smart offensive possessions. They are a good defensive half-court team. They're going to try to lull you to sleep and contain you. Make them pay for what they do. If they lay off of you, you shoot the three. If they lay off of you guys, take the shot, attack the basket. Make them pay. They cannot stay with you guys. All right? Guys, know what this game is worth. You know what is at stake for you. Let's go.
FSU on three. 1, 2, 3. FSU!
First couple minutes, make sure you guys just be patient, stay calm. Always, always, always rely on your defense. Box out, rebound, and we go down the floor and attack. Let's go. Have some fun out there today, guys. Let's go.
Team on three. 1, 2, 3. Team.
Good job, Clyde! Hand up, hand up, hand up!
Coach McDonald was looking concerned. The Lady Knights hadn't scored in almost 4 minutes.
And one, good job, knee!
Haddon Township fought back with a three-pointer by Jess Brown. Late in the first quarter, Kylie O'Donnell helped give the Lady Knights the lead. Just before the end of the first quarter, Rachel Hodge helped increase the lead.
All right, if your girl sets a screen, if like your girl comes and sets a screen, Mike, and make sure we show for a second and help her through those screens, okay? Every time somebody cuts, bump them a little bit. Give them a couple shots. You guys are absolutely killing them on the boards right now. Every rebound belongs to you guys, and settle down on the free throws. That's something else you guys are good at. Knock down the foul shots, all right? Keep it up, guys. Let's go. Take it to them all the time. Don't take one single possession off. Let's go.
Hard work on three. One, two, three.
Hard work.
Some hard work by Tianjay Lewis early on in the second helped keep the lead. Monica Birch got into the act with a three-pointer and forced Haddon Township into a timeout.
Protect the three-point line, make them drive. Make them go to the basket. That's not what they're comfortable at doing, okay? Keep up the defense, rebound. Whenever you get the opportunity, head down the floor. All right, great job. Keep it up.
Let's
not
go.
One possession off.
Hard work on three.
Haddon Township did exactly what Coach McDonald didn't want them to do. The Lady Knights held the lead going into the half, but no basket was easy.
If we call three, this is for you, okay? Well, it says the ball up here. Whoever the guard is, if it's Kylie, Anissa, Tyra, TJ, just start right here in the block. Rachel, you're going to start on that side. Whoever's the opposite foot, Anissa, if you're in, it might be you, okay? So let's say it's Hodge. Kylie, go through. Ball shovel over, we have an isolation right here. They are going to double you. I'm sure they're going to double you. If you can take her, take her. Rachel Hodge, flash high right there. Rachel will be there. If you get doubled, you have Hodge for a kick out right here. Whatever guard has gone through, if this is Kylie, just hang out in the corner, spot up. Everybody move to an open spot, because if Rachel doesn't have something, she will find you guys. Okay? Three, whatever we call is for TJ. Get in that block. Whoever's over here, it doesn't matter. Don't go crazy and try to set up. Go through, cross your loop, entry pass into TJ, start well on that block. As the ball comes in, wait till for it to get in, then you can pull high. Okay? We want to try to isolate you in the post. Jess Brown also has three fouls. We're not going to set up anything. You're sure there to go at her, but if for some reason, like Tyra, for example, she's on you and we're running maxes, go right at her. And let's see if we can keep her on the bench, okay? What is going to be the key for you guys to be successful in the second half?
Taking care of the ball.
Boxing out. You guys have to rebound. There's a couple of possessions.
9 offensive rebounds.
But they got second chances. And the 1 second chance or 2 second chances turns into a three, and that kills the momentum. Okay, we can't let that happen. You guys have to play defense, and you have to box out. The defense is great. Rebounding needs a little bit of work, okay? Defense, box out, rebound. Offensively, take care of the ball. Make them play defense. They have to scramble. They're chasing you guys. Attack offensively. We can attack. We do not have to force anything. If they want to sag off you guys and play that defense that they're doing, run through 52. Make them work for a little bit, and then we attack. Okay? The game belongs to you. Stay in control. All right? Let's go. All business out there, girls. When you guys go out there and warm up, visualize what we're going to do in the second half. Okay? Let's go.
Team 130. 1, 2, 3. Team!
Starting the second half, Haddon Township showed they were ready to play.
Offensively, set toll down. If you're going to go to the basket, don't even think about it. Take it and go to the basket. Defensively, have to protect the three-point line. Have to protect the three-point line. Cannot take a possession off because an eight-point lead turns to a three-point lead like that. All right? They made their run. They feel good about themselves. Settle down and let's play. Let's go.
Come on. Team on three. 1, 2, 3.
Team. Here we go. Come on, Haji. Need you, kid. Let's go. That was really bad.
Nisa Sanchez gave the Lady Knights some breathing room.
Go at her, Nisa! And one, and one!
Get a five, get a five!
Coach McDonald really started getting into the game.
Come down to who's mentally tougher and who chooses not to fall asleep on defense. You guys have to, if any time you chose not to take a possession off, it's now. Everybody has to bear down and everybody has to focus. We need a big defensive possession right here and offensively continue to take care of the ball. When the shot goes up, everyone must box out, must rebound. Be strong with the ball. They're getting frustrated and they're getting physical. I'm trying to be on the rest. There's not a do about it. You guys have to control it by boxing out and rebounding and keep your composure. Okay? Fight through the screens. If the screen comes, everybody make sure you keep a hand up on that three. They're going to look for the first open shot they get. All right? Bear down. Stay together. Let's go.
Defense on three. One, two, three.
Defense.
Rachel Hodge converted on the play the coach called in the huddle. Kylie O'Donnell hit a big shot to give the biggest lead of the game to the Lady Knights. In a matter of seconds, Haddon Township hit a three and was right back in the game.
Everybody must bear down on defense. We don't have to score. We have to take care of the ball. Each possession, we run 52. We keep taking a couple of seconds off the clock. If they jump, and you attack, everybody must crash the boards. Stay focused on defense. Let's go.
Let's go. Defense on three. One, two, three. Defense.
Tanjay Lewis then made a huge play. It then became a game of foul shots, and the Lady Knights would go on to the win.
Cried their eyes out.
I remember that.
After we lost in the playoff game. And I never forget it. Daniel Fox was like, T, you shouldn't cry, you shouldn't worry about it because you still have another chance. And tonight, baby, we shut them Hawks up.
That was that chance.
We clipped their wings.
We made Hawk burgers!
Sterling Lady Knights, you know where we're from, South Jersey's number one.
Okay.
Yeah.
We just play Haddon Township because they some bums.
The defense stopped Jess Brown, got a gun. Katie Gensinger walked away with none. And it was a whole lot of fun.
Them, I think, four times in the past 2 years in fall. we've learned a lot about the type of team they are, and they're nuts. And I preface that by saying they are very animated, emotional on the court. Their fans are emotional, and the most important thing, I think, is not getting wrapped up in their game.
We end up matching up with them really well. I know that if we get them out their game, then they're done. If we can't run like transition game with them because they're just as fast as us. So we'll just have to make them play like half court offense, like that. We're trying to do.
But it all comes down to the game. And when we beat them in fall league, it was like, you know, we're number one.
They're a really good team, and we match up very similar. They have a big girl that's a freshman last year that they didn't have last year, who she's pretty good. She'll bang in there with TJ and Rachel, and they'll do a good job with her, I think.
Obviously, they're good. They're number two. Now, off the court, they have some issues. They are, I don't understand. They're like cocky, and they like to talk a lot of trash. I'll hand it to them. They're a good team. They can get the job done.
Their outside game is very similar to ours, but they can shoot from the outside. They get to the basket. I think the biggest thing they do is like as soon as they get the rebound, they just run. Like that's their game, and we like to play that game. But it's going to be really important to do it to our extent, to run when we can, but not get out of control.
Right now is a culmination of what these girls have been working for 4 years. And they want nothing more to be in this game, on the stage, to be challenged, to be in front of a lot of people, and to finally have the chance to be what they've wanted to be for the past 4 years.
We are ready for this game, and I think it's going to show, you know,
Number one versus number two game. You probably have never had that chance again in your life.
So for me personally, it was like a little nerve-wracking, and I was sore and achy, but there wasn't anything else I would have rather done than play in that game.
We were all nervous, but we didn't really want to show it. We wanted to show them that we were calm and ready to play.
The girls have been working for 4 years to be in that game, in that position, on our home floor, number one versus number two. And I knew in my heart that they weren't going to back down from the challenge.
Like they always start off with. Rebound by Monica Birch. Up the court to O'Donnell. She takes her shot. There's the first pass open. Down low to Hodge. So she gets her own rebound, puts it up. Down low to Hodge, she's gonna take the shot. And there is her second basket, 4 points for the night. Three-pointer is in. Foul is on Jasmine Lewis, her first, team's fifth. Down low to Sanchez, she puts it up, goes in. Grant Cook is by, looking to see what they have open. And Jasmine Lewis, her first basket of the night.
Two successive times down the floor, they've gotten the points off of just individual drives of the basket, so Strong's just got to do a much better job there.
Good answer back by Tyra Satchel, her first basket of the night. Birch to Lewis. She puts up the shot, and good job. Nice athletic move by Anissa Sanchez.
Right in the rim, but Tanjay Lewis did a nice job of just putting good position defense there.
Good job by Rachel Hodge. That's her third basket of the afternoon. 6 points.
Amidst controversy, RV shot out of the gate quickly in the second half.
Down low to Lewis. And there we go. Four. Late in the third quarter. And once again, Sterling letting them go. And once again, they let her go.
Too many uncontested drives to the basket.
6 point lead. Shot in by Monica Birch. And Miss McDonald really trusting her. 3-pointer is in. Ball over to Birch. She takes the three. It's in. Sterling nailed down two.
Yeah, a lot of physical play away from ball between Lauren Gaskill and Monica Birch. And you see right there, Lauren Gaskill winning that battle away from.
Kylie shot. Bounces around a couple
KJ,
times.
Got it.
Lewis puts it in. Now Sterling only down 2 points. Lob pass. And Moses makes her shot.
The game close.
Skip pass to Hodge.
Over to Monica.
Monica makes it.
Sterling then took their first lead since the first quarter.
Tangier will get it back.
There we go.
And here we'll take the lead right here.
With Sterling on defense, the unthinkable happened.
In her face.
Get it! And they're going to get the ball.
Monica looks like she's hurt, though.
Got elbowed there. So we look at, oh, she headbutted her. Excuse me.
That's a huge push-off.
Yeah, and you could see, like, as we look at Monica first.
Somebody like Monica goes down. It's very hard to regain your composure. But we had been through things like that before. We knew she was hurt. I don't think anybody knew she her nose was broken at that time. And she just had ice in her veins. And her courage and her her motivation to stay in the game calmed and inspired everybody else to finish the game out.
We were obviously all scared. First, we thought, you know, concussion, you know, is she going to be okay? First, not even thinking about her coming back into the game. And then the fact that she gets up, and she comes back, and she's done it for the past 4 years. And
the game went into overtime, and things really got crazy.
The strip. There's Monica Burch all alone. She's got to
take her time
this.
On this.
There we go.
There it is.
Good job by Monica. Monica with 12 points.
We're going to try a two-man game right here.
And that's off rebounded by Lewis.
Two-man game's not working.
And an answer back by Moses.
The Lady Knights then caught a break.
Both sides really slowing it down.
One second.
Foul is going to be on Moses.
And Moses is out of the
foul.
Game.
That's her.
She's
that's
gone.
It. She's gone. She's gone from this game. And I'll tell you why.
Yeah, push.
You know, we were saying how Rachel Hodge and Lauren Moses both had four fouls. I think it works against Rancocas Valley more to lose Lauren Moses because even
after trailing a few seconds later, Kylie O'Donnell made the shot of the season.
Give it to her again.
There it is. There it is.
There we go, Kylie. That was huge.
When she shot the shot in the RV game and drilled that three, it was almost eerie because it was the same exact spot that she caught and launched it from the Camden game the year before. And she shot it, and, like, I knew it was going in. And the place went bananas. And I was so happy for the girls and so happy for Kylie because she's – Kylie's the kind of kid that has played that shot over and over and over and over in her head, in the backyard, in the gym, and she wants to take that. She wants to take that shot. So at that situation, I don't want the ball in anybody else's hands. I know Monica's going to get her the ball in the right spot, and Kylie's going to throw it up, and it went in, and we finished the game out. And it was, I get goosebumps still even talking about it.
And then I got the rebound. She was open again, and that was the only person I saw, so I passed it to her, and I was like, Kylie, shoot. And when she shot, she made it. She was so happy. It was good. It was like trusting your players and knowing what they can do is the best thing to know.
Somebody got me the ball on the wing for the first shot, and I thought it was good. Like, it looked good, everything, and it didn't go in. Kind of moves around the perimeter, and Monica, again, comes up with the ball somehow, kicks it out, and you don't even hesitate at this point. It's just muscle memory. You catch, you're open, and I like that spot, and I just let it go. And for it to go in, that was just, like, such a weight off my shoulders and I think off the teams because we were in a little bit of a drought there, and to tie that up there, put the pressure on them.
The Lady Knights then sealed the game from the foul line, remaining number one in South Jersey.
Monica makes her first. She's got ice in her veins at times. Misses the second. She's going to be shooting too.
Sterling at this point, 6 for 16 from the line. Two shots being made. That's pretty much it. With one shot being made, I'm sure Christian coach is saying play tough defense, but don't foul. You don't want to foul in that situation.
Right. Yeah. She makes her first.
That might be it.
It felt great. It was like everything we worked for, it paid off. Just preparing for that game specifically, number one beats number two, it was great.
It felt amazing. It was like a championship game because playing them in fall lead and summer lead and all that, they didn't think we could beat them, and we knew that we could beat them.
Like, so that's the game that we worked 4 years to get to, and we did it, one versus two, and, you know, we beat them, and it was just that feeling like our hard work was paying off. That's what it felt like. All right.
Well, it was kind of bittersweet because we won, and everyone, like, I went into the locker room and about ready to carry on, and everyone was like, shh, because Monica was sitting there, like, kind of crumpled, you know, in the corner, and we wanted to go bananas and celebrate, but at the same time, you know, our floor general was obviously in a lot of pain, so everybody was really worried about
her. Who's going to stay in their man? They got to make sure they move their feet.
And it's over. No, no, wait. It's over.
That's it.
Sterling wins.
Done.
50-46.
Very nice win.
Over Rancocas Valley.
Amazing win.
Stay tuned for a post-game show.
Hey, you see a very excited Coach McDonald, excited crowd. What a game. Definitely lived up to the advanced billing. I mean, you couldn't ask for anything better than this.
It's hard to believe it's been over 3 years since we first saw Kylie O'Donnell and Monica Birch score their first points on TV.
Dribbles it back out. Thought about passing it down low to O'Donnell. Birch drives in and shoots it. Nice play by Monica Birch. Trying to find their offensive rhythm. O'Donnell with the long three. Goes in. Nice shot by O'Donnell.
Earlier in the season, Kylie O'Donnell scored her 1,000th point.
Cross court to O'Donnell. She takes the shot. And there it is! Number 1,000 for Kylie O'Donnell.
Tonight it's Monica Birch's turn, as she'll become the 18th girl in the history of Sterling High School to score 1,000 points. So tonight we celebrate history. Monica Birch goes for 1,000 right here on Channel 19.
Playing with Monica has been a real, just an ultimate great experience, because I've never played with someone who will build you up as much as she does.
Coming into my freshman year, I never saw a point guard like that. I mean, she's quick, she's fast, she can handle the ball, and she can also give passes. So she's just an all-around player.
But I think the best part is how she got there. You know, she was hurt at least once every 4 years, and with the face mask and everything, it just, I told her I'd wear it with her if she needed confidence or something like that. But that 1,000 points was a great feeling. It's rare that a coach gets two players with 1,000 points in 1 year, let alone one.
For me, was very typical of Monica. She's not one to get a ton of fanfare and a ton of attention, and she didn't need all that kind of stuff. And I think everybody wanted to celebrate for her more than she wanted to celebrate for herself, because she,
for her to get it on what she got it on, like a rebound, like a junk basket, it's kind of, it just shows that she's not a one-dimensional player. Like, she doesn't have to just take it to me. Like, she's everywhere, and for her to be cleaning up a play like that, it kind of showed, like, this kid does it all. And
when I scored my 1,000 points, it was shocking, because I don't know, when I was little, I didn't think that I would be this serious about basketball. So being in high school and being a star for 4 years and having my name somewhere where I could remember it and come back and see it, it felt good to know that I am somewhere in school, in the school history.
Nice job. She's looking down the floor. There it is.
There it is.
Just let the moment, do it itself here.
Second player this season for Sterling Lady Knights, Monica Birch, and now 1,001 points.
She took care of that early, didn't she?
This is just a great honor.
I like it. All right. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Congratulations, Monica Birch.
Accepting presents from family and friends. This is a nice tradition for this team, All South Jersey, this year.
Will they ever get a shot of the Lady Knight 1,000 point scorers? Here's a replay here. You have Tyra with the miss. Monica with a great rebound. Going to put it in. Just
nice and simple.
Nothing else better.
No nervousness at all.
This has been an amazing season for our girls basketball team. And on top of the team effort, we have two individuals that have done awesome. I'd just like to say congratulations to Kylie O'Donnell and Monica Birch on attaining their 1,000 points. Great job, girls. Go Knights.
Congratulations, Kylie and Monica.
Good luck in your future.
Congrats, Monica, on your 1,000th point. Good job, boss. Good job, Kai. 1,000 points, baby. Way to go.
Congratulations, Kylie and Monica, on your 1,000 points. Congratulations and good luck in the season.
Kylie, Monica, great job. Congratulations on your 1,000 points. You guys are awesome, and we enjoyed you in preschool. Best wishes.
Congratulations on your 1,000th point, ladies.
Congratulations on your 1,000 points, Kylie and Monica. Good luck with the rest of your season.
Just want to say congratulations to Kylie and to Monica for your 1,000 points achievement. Good luck the rest of the way and bring home that Group 2 title. You're both great kids and enjoy having you in this school. We're going to miss you when you're gone.
Good job, Monica. Good job, Kylie. Let's get a good win in here today and then bring home the title for us Knights.
Congratulations, Kylie and Monica. It's a great accomplishment and best of luck in the future on our way to the championship.
Hey, Kylie, Monica, congratulations on 1,000 points, and I'm glad you listened when I taught you everything about basketball.
Congratulations to you both, Monica and Kylie, for a wonderful season in the last 4 years and reaching your 1,000 points. Good luck in the future. Go Knights.
Hey, Kylie and Monica, congratulations on scoring 1,000 points. I think that's 2,000 total, if I'm not mistaken. Congrats.
Rocky and the boss, Dr. V here. Want to congratulate you, Rock, on 1,000 points, first game. Great job. You led off the season the right way. And boss, I know you're getting ready to get it, or you probably already got it in the first half against Audubon and the Wave. Good luck the rest of the way. And remember, K-N-I-G-H-T-S, you're the Knights and you're the best.
Congratulations, both Monica and Kylie, on an outstanding individual achievement. It's been my pleasure and honor to be able to have watched you guys over the last 4 years and looking forward to reading about your accomplishments in the future. Good luck.
Kylie and Monica, congratulations. It's been a pleasure to watch you. Good luck as you keep going and your leadership skills and obviously your experience is going to take you very far. It's definitely a pleasure and enjoyment to watch you, so good luck.
Congratulations, guys. It's rare that two people in one season get 1,000 points, and I'm proud to say that Sterling has two of you guys. Congrats.
Kylie, Monica, congratulations on your 1,000 points. It's a great accomplishment. Congratulations on a great season, and I look forward to watching the rest of it.
Congratulations, Monica and Kylie. It's been fun watching you guys, and good luck in your future.
Kylie and Monica, I just want to congratulate you on your accomplishment of 1,000 points. I know you're greater team players than individual players, but that's certainly a great accomplishment, and congratulate you and hope the best in the playoffs.
I just want to give a congratulations to Kylie and Monica, the boss, for scoring 1,000 points, and I wish the girls' basketball team good luck for the rest of the season and go get them in the playoffs.
Hey Kylie, hey Monica, congratulations on scoring 1,000 points. We knew there was nothing better coming from our Sterling Knights than you two girls. We wish you luck with basketball this year and in the future. Great job.
Just wanted to congratulate Kylie O'Donnell, Monica Birch on their 1,000 point season. These young ladies, I've watched them since freshman year. They have grown tremendously as individuals and as a team. I look forward to great things this year, finishing up the season. Good luck, and wish you all the best. And go Knights.
First of all, I want to congratulate Monica on scoring her 1,000th point here in the basketball game, and what a wonderful young lady she is. I have her in class, and she's quite an athlete and a wonderful student, and nobody deserves it more than Monica. Congratulations, and best of luck, and in your future too, girl. All right, shoot the stars.
Congratulations, Kylie and Monica, on behalf of the Sterling Swim Team. Nice job on 1,000 points, and as always, go Knights.
I'm Coach Atene here at Sterling High School. Just want to wish Kylie O'Donnell congratulations on our 1,000th point. It's a great accomplishment. I'm friends with the family. It's great watching you grow up into a great young woman. And also, Monica, congratulations to you. You've been great, and good luck in the future to both of you guys. If you ever need anything, you know I'm here. Go Knights.
Monica and Kylie, congratulations to you both on scoring 1,000 points this year. Great accomplishment. Number one team in South Jersey. You girls deserve everything that you get. Best of luck the rest of the season, and best of luck in both of your futures. Go Knights.
Congratulations, Monica and Kylie. 1,000 points, great accomplishment. Two great young ladies. Good job.
Monica and Kylie, congratulations on getting 1,000 points. You guys are great players and more importantly, great kids. And good luck the rest of the way.
Congratulations, Monica and Kylie. I'm so glad that you could get this far. I'm so happy for you and I love you both.
Congratulations to both Monica and Kylie on your 1,000th point. It is a wonderful accomplishment and I couldn't have seen it gone to two better young ladies. Good luck in the future and let's go get some more accomplishments.
Kylie and Monica, I just want to congratulate you guys on scoring 1,000 points this year. I think it's an unbelievable feat. You never see two teammates doing it in the same season, so I think it's a testament to your hardworking and your work ethic and your achievements overall as not just leaders on the court, but the fantastic ability that you display night in and night out. So let's keep up the good work and hopefully we'll bring home a state title this year.
Congratulations, Kylie. Congratulations, Monica, on your great achievement here at Sterling High School. It's been a great 4 years knowing you guys. Best of luck to you in the future.
Monica and Kylie, welcome to the 1,000 Point Club. What a milestone. And I'll tell you something else. As your teacher of computer graphics, you ladies are truly Renaissance ladies. You're not only athletes, you're artists. You're wonderful citizens and a pleasure to teach. You're a credit to the school, and you represent us nobly on the basketball court. Congratulations.
Girls, congratulations on your 1,000 points. It's been great watching you the last 4 years. It's been a blast putting all your games on TV. So here's to a great end to a season, and let's bring home a title. Go Knights.
Kylie and Monica, congratulations on 1,000 points each. And let's keep the points coming, and let's work towards that South Jersey championship.
Boss and Kylie, just want to say congratulations on your 1,000 points. It's a tremendous accomplishment. It doesn't come easy. It's 4 years of hard work and a lot of summer spent sweating and playing and giving up a lot of fun stuff and sacrificing. Welcome to the 1,000 Point Club. I couldn't be prouder to be the coach of two outstanding young ladies with fabulous families. You deserve everything you have coming to you. And after this is over, we have lots of more games to win, championships to win, and a great season to look forward to. And I love you guys.
Everyone saying that it didn't look like it was us out there. It didn't even look like we wanted to play. And honestly, like when we sat back and thought about it, it really didn't seem like we were a team that night. And it's not like we went out there not caring. I think we just were full of ourselves. And you never want to get big-headed, especially being the number one team in South Jersey.
I guess, and it was also a wake-up call that we need to be prepared for every team and not to take any team lightly, because I remember that game, everybody was coming out slow. And then the second half, when we decided to pick it up, it was too late.
That was a true wake-up call for us. And I don't want to be the captain that says, we should win every game, because that's not always, it's not that it's not possible, but it's not always feasible.
We lost the games for ourselves. There were times in the games where we didn't show up. We didn't show our Sterling fashion. We didn't play the way we play. And like on and off the court, where it was kind of sketchy. Right.
I don't think everyone was on the same page that game. It was kind of like we went into the game with our heads kind of like, yeah, we could beat them. They can't beat us.
But Haddonfield is like our rival, and we never want to lose to Haddonfield. But I think we underestimated maybe a little bit, how good they actually were. The first time we played them, we won by like 15 or 16 or something like that. And
We left that Haddonfield game, and I was just confused because I did not know what team was on the floor that day. And I think we learned from that game that we were vulnerable. We were not invincible. It kept us going. It was motivating for us. It was such a disappointing loss. I think it really made us mad as a team.
Done.
50-46.
they pretty much came for blood, and they were going to do whatever it took to take us down. And sadly, we gave up a lot, and we obviously didn't play our hardest.
We did come out slow. We missed a lot of shots. They forced a lot of turnovers. By the time when we got down, there was like we couldn't come back. And I guess it taught us as a team that we need to come out hard every game, whether we beat the team or not.
We ended up with doing the wrong things and doing the right things. And they kind of just matched that and scored every time.
RV came, you know, with blood in their eyes. They were really mad that they lost the last time. And, you know, maybe, not that we didn't take them seriously, but they stepped it up a notch above what we did. They were better than us that day. You know, like I said, it was disappointing, but that's a team that, you know, went on to win a Group 4 state championship, and we did beat them at one point. I wish that it was a better game, you know, for the fans.
Again, you just kind of have to say, wow, like, RV played a really good game. They played really good defense. They played, you know, they scored when they had to score. And I think that it just showed that, you know, if we play 10 times, you know, it might be 5-5.
You know, you really can't say that they beat us, that they could have been number one over top of us. It's still tied, 1-1. You'd have to bring the old team back for a rematch if you really want to know who is better.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Sterling High School for the South Jersey Invitational Basketball Tournament Championship between the number one Rancocas Valley Red Devils and the number two Sterling Silver Lady Knights. For RV to go down low into Moses.
Into Lewis and Lauren Moses.
Expect that throughout the night. Kylie turns it over.
And she's in the same situation as Lauren Gaskill. Nice pass there.
Looking for something open. She's got Kylie. Kylie with the deep three now. And she connects. Huge three for Sterling.
Yeah. And one that she let go out of bounds, but it turned out to be RV ball, but nonetheless rebounded by Tanjay Lewis, and here comes Monica pressing up. Nice scoop there by Monica. Lauren Moses' first foul. I know she was in foul trouble in the last game. Kylie for three, nails it! Kylie O'Donnell from downtown.
But that's Sterling. As close as Sterling would get. It would be RV the rest of the way.
A split. And one there. These teams are so evenly matched up. Nice drive to the basket there. Natalia Lee, and the foul is going to be on Rachel Hodge. That was in that second half after picking up her second in the early second quarter.
Open three, connected, all on the ground, rebounded by RV. Open for the three. And that goes in for Rancocas Valley.
Players right there.
3:30 to go in the fourth. A lucky bounce right there.
A big rivalry's developed, not only here, but it started in the summer. And this is a tough loss. And I don't think Sterling played their best. Yeah,
obviously, there was turnovers at certain times, but RV just seemed to get more offense from more players.
We definitely came into that game ready to play and showing them that no matter how hard they worked, we worked just as hard, if not harder.
Well, I guess we pretty much knew that we were going to win that game, and we weren't going to let somebody like West Effort take the South Jersey championship from us.
And Kylie hates West Effort with a passion, and I think it's just, I won't go names, but I think it's more of just one specific girl, but the fact that she plays for West Effort just doesn't sit well with Kai. So Kylie was definitely pumped about that game.
West Effort is one of those teams you just really dislike. I don't want to use the word hate, but you just really dislike them. And it was a game that we knew we couldn't take lightly because of the fact that it's the third time we're playing them. The first two times, they always keep it close somehow before we can pull away. And, you know, we just kind of said from the beginning, like, we can't mess around here. Like, we can't dance.
West Effort playoff game, I was extremely nervous about just because they're in our conference. We had played them twice already. They're a very well-coached, and I think talented team. I think they're going to be a really big test coming up in the future. But to play a team three times, you never know what can happen. If you take somebody lightly, or you fall asleep, or you have a bad shooting day. And
they just came in and just absolutely picked that team apart, which was really good. I was very relieved.
Monica Birch on her three. Down low to Tanjay, who puts it up and gets the first bucket of the night. Over to Kylie O'Donnell, who's going to take the three. And she drains it. Kylie O'Donnell down low to Birch. Remaining.
They're not playing bad at all. I mean, West Deptford's just hanging in there. And you see Kylie O'Donnell hit the three. The half-court offense allows them to open things up. It really opens up opportunity.
Here comes another one.
Kylie on fire from three-point range. Birch is going to put up the two. Tipped around a bit. Rebound by Sanchez. Puts it off the glass and gets her first bucket of the night.
That's just real good positional defense right there. And again, that's something we've been seeing all night.
And Hodge puts up the two. And gets the
We're staying around in games.
And Birch just drives in there.
Hit by Anissa Sanchez.
Monica with the deep two.
And Gloucester and Paulsboro are some of the top teams in that.
And Lewis puts it off. Dishes it over to Birch. They're up in transition. Over to Lewis. Now O'Donnell going to take the shot. Lewis is going to drive, put it up. Muscles her way through. Yeah. Satchel puts up the off-court shot. And Lewis there can score. Down low to Sanchez, who muscles her way through.
And as you see, Kyra Satchel finish off right here.
I believe that was deflected.
Yeah, and I think we're just looking at a West Deptford team that's just worn down right now.
Tonight, the playoff pressure increases as we are now down to the final four in South Jersey Group 2. Tonight's opponent is a familiar foe in Willingboro, a team the Lady Knights have beaten once last year and once this year. But the game will be much tougher now because the Camaras point guard and their second leading scorer returns to the lineup tonight. She is someone the Lady Knights have to be ready for.
So I'm kind of looking forward to playing them because I actually don't like hearing about this point guard. And I know, like, I'm way better than her, so I'm just ready
to show challenges.
Her.
That's
yeah,
good.
I'm just
That's
ready
good.
To show her what I got, and I'm going to shut her down.
I think that we're going to take the same approach and do what we do. Of course, shut Owens down, but she's a good player, and she's going to hit shots.
It's going to be a battle. They are a very athletic team. They have one player that's scoring about 22, 23
Owens.
Points a game.
Yes.
She's a really good player.
The winner goes to the South Jersey Group 2 Championship. Up next, right here on Channel 19.
Willingboro is now the team that stands between you and the Group 2 Finals.
Same kind of game plan as West Deptford. They're looking to get to the basket. You guys have to contain the drive. Now force them to be uncomfortable and shoot the outside shots. Keys to winning. Number one is your rebounding. You've been annihilating people on the boards. We have to make sure we do it again tonight. This is a very good rebounding team. They're very athletic. They can jump. So you got to box them out and make sure they only get one shot. Number two, aggressive team defense. Make sure we contain the drive. Make sure you guys absolutely commit to the help every single time. 23 starts to get to the basket, shut that door right in front of her face. Make sure the help is there. And last, make sure every possession counts offensively. No forcing any bad shots. Guys, get a rebound. If you have it under the basket, we take it up. If not, we kick it out and we restart the offense. Take care of the ball. We have to limit the turnovers. They set up and press. Make sure we set up and press break and do all the little things right today. All right? Let's go, girl.
From the start. 2-1-3. 1-2-3. Team!
Intense game all together, being able to watch them play other teams throughout, like
tournament games, we would watch them and see if we have to play them, we know who we have to shut down and where we have to be on the court.
That, and they were always talking trash, always loud, for no reason, and we beat them that time. But this playoff game, this was the third time I knew I had to stick Micaiah, and I knew what I was expecting. And shutting her down was the essential part of the whole team because everything ran through her.
I think in that game we showed that when you stick together and play as a team, you definitely can win. We had the experience, and we're a four-year team, and they were new in the game, freshman, sophomore, and we were more of a senior-based team. And I think that showed the leadership, the experience, the knowledge of the game of basketball.
You talk about one of those games that is, defensive the whole way through. I just remember being in that game and being exhausted. Like, the defense on both sides, I mean, it was a lot closer than the first game. We knew what they were capable of. Micaiah Owens is, like, outstanding player, and we knew that shutting her down was going to be key, but also had to play solid defense all the way around.
It was a very scary game. We were up and kind of took the foot off the gas. Something that happened in Hatfield. Very similar. It was like a mirror light game. It was really weird, but we managed to hang on and get it done in the end. And we had a defensive strategy that I thought was pretty good. We watched what their best player did, where she took every shot from, and we absolutely slammed every door in her face. Every lane she had to cut down, we had help there. Tyra was an absolute animal on that girl the whole entire game. The help was there the entire time.
Key baskets for Willingboro down the stretch.
Kara Cesar puts up the shot. Birch drives, puts up the shot, and there's the first two for the Lady Knights, Monica Birch.
The full court press now.
Sterling, an excellent job breaking the presses in the other two games, as we see Rachel Hodge put up her first basket tonight.
Good job of cutting off that lane, cutting off the pass. Micaiah Owens, she's at her most dangerous, and she's in the open floor.
Bennett puts up her first two-pointer.
Here, obviously tied 6-6, but these teams match up very well against each other. Nice
Hodge
shot there
by Hodge.
Hodge
puts it off the glass. 4 points.
Going
to try to get the ball to Bennett. Over to Owens. He puts up the shot. Birch is going to drive, put it up, get the bounce.
Familiar territory here for Kylie O'Donnell, starting out scoreless. She came out on fire the last couple games. And speaking of on fire, Micaiah Owens.
Drives, dishes it out to Satchel. She's going to put it up. And Sanchez gets the two.
Another strong.
Ball blocked by Kylie O'Donnell. Satchel going to bring it up, put it up, and one!
Just before the half, Willingboro took the lead, but not for long.
He comes from behind and knocked the ball away.
And now Willingboro has the one-point lead. Monica going to put up the awkward shot, and it goes in! Count the basket!
Really, I didn't plan on making that. It was just kind of getting a good angle on the basket. And when I made it, the atmosphere just went from 0 to 10 that fast.
With action right here. Monica Birch coming off the floor. Little off bounce. I don't know if she meant to bank it, but what a way to head into halftime.
To see that go in and to see us just take the lead on that, not only does it deflate them, you could look at their faces and see, like, that's just a dagger to anybody. Right. And that's
both Monica Birch for Sterling and Micaiah Owens for Willingboro. You take another look at it. That was just a desperation shot. Shoot it up before the buzzer, and why not? Everything else went in that quarter for
opportunity.
Tyra's going to drive, put up the shot. Not a very high-scoring quarter for both sides. Sanchez gets a rebound off the glass, and it all tied up. 6:40 to go in the fourth quarter. Lewis is going to drive and get it to fall.
In a close game, Rachel Hodge hit the biggest shot of her career.
Hodge going to take the shot, and it goes in.
What a
five-point lead.
What a huge jumper right there.
All week in practice and the last couple games, like, I haven't been making shots, and I've been airballing or overshooting. And I was just like, please, this game, like, let me break out of that shell. And I squared up, and I was like, in my head, please do not airball. and I took the longest time, and finally got up, and I just watched it, and I heard the crowd above me, and I'm like, it's going in, it's going in, and I just got so excited, but, you know, I had to keep composure. We still had a minute left, and it was just so amazing.
With a few seconds left, the Lady Knights got a big scare.
They're going to have to foul. Letting her go too much before the foul, and that'll do it.
Monica Bird's putting on a clinic right now, but
Monica,
she gets
just
fouled
hit her head
hard.
On the floor.
Right now. Not sure what she...
Look at the replay right here.
Watch her as she comes to get spun around and set.
Ooh.
Hits her head right on the three-point line there. And athletic trainer Sean Klenk out there right now to take a look at Monica as she's sitting up.
The injury in that game, I wasn't expected to go down that way. But it kind of just happened, I guess. You had to foul me sooner or later. I don't think it was intentionally. I think they was just trying to foul me. When I fell and hit my head, it was kind of like I was dizzy, so I didn't know like what was going on. The first time I tried to get up, it was like, all right, I'm okay. But then when I went back down, I was like, yeah, I'm not okay.
And that's going to do it. The Lady Knights are going to go on to the Group 2 state championship this Tuesday.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, what a great team effort. I mean, you know, Monica Perch was her typical self late in the game, handling the ball. But, you know, this was just a real gritty effort.
This is the moment, this is the day, this is the moment when I know I'm on my way. Every endeavor I have made ever is coming into play, it's here and now, today. This is the moment, this is the hour, when I can open up tomorrow like a flower, and put my hand to everything I plan to, fulfill my grand design, see all my stars align. This is the moment, my final test. Destiny beckoned, I never reckon second best. I won't let down, I must not fall. This is the moment, the sweetest moment.
Is now the last team that stands between you and winning the Group 2 championship. Tyra, you're starting on Kelly Hughes, number 23. The two of you have to be glued to her at all times. As soon as she comes across half court, she needs a defender on her. Can't wait for her to catch the ball and wait to stick a hand up. It's got to be in her face all the time. So when you guys go out there, you have to defend the three-point line. If they get an inch of breathing room, they're shooting. And then they're shooting. You have to make sure you keep your hands at all times. Make sure you guys jump to the ball and make sure that you bump the cutters. You're going to run a lot of cuts across the lane. Anytime somebody goes to cut, you've got to step up and knock them around a little bit. Make them go behind you. Nobody gets a free pass cut across the basket. Make sure you guys defend the back door cuts. Just keep them in front of you the whole entire time and keep your hand up. Play straight up defense and you guys will be fine. And make sure you guys get back in transition. As far as keys to winning, aggressive team defense, you have to defend the three-point line and make sure that somebody is covered at all times.
If they get back in transition, stop the ball, and everybody match up with somebody until you can switch back, because they all are going to try to shoot the ball. Secondly, you make sure that every possession counts. You guys have to take care of the ball tonight. Take care of it against the press. Take care of it against the 1-3-1. Make sure we get good, simple passes, and we get good open looks at the basket. If we don't have anything, we pull it out, and we keep moving the ball around. We need some time off the clock. And lastly, everybody's got to crash the boards, especially in that 1-3-1. Hit the offensive glass and make sure they only get one shot. All right, ladies, the time is now. Let's go get it done. This is what we work for home court, ladies. Let's go write your own history tonight, girls.
From the start, two, one, three, 1, 2, 3, team! Well, that team is coming into our gym right now. They think they can take it from us. Our championship, which we've worked 4 years for. So.
Exciting to see that all our fans will be there and how everyone wore white and how many supporters we had that game.
It was a lot different than any other lead-up game. The school, the gym was getting packed extremely early. Normally we have about an hour to ourselves and we can all just goof around, stretch, eat, shoot around. Like, you knew this was a big game because just everybody was there, the vibe was different. We were all, I think we had our jitters. Who wouldn't? It was the first time that we were in a championship game.
We reached out to student body. We said, like, let's do a whiteout. Let's do this big. We wanted packed stands. We were afraid, you know, Point Pleasant Barrow was going to bring a lot of people. We wanted to make sure that home court advantage was home court advantage. We said, hey, like, let's do a whiteout. And I don't think we could have asked for a better response from the school. And that just says a lot about Sterling. It says a lot about our school spirit. It says a lot about our support. We've got so much of it over the years. I'd say that was one of the coolest feelings I've ever had, and it's one of those things that you'll never forget.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Sterling High School for tonight's South Jersey Group 2 State Championship between the number 1 Sterling Lady Knights and the number 3 Point Pleasant Panthers.
Unfortunately for the Lady Knights, Point Pleasant Barrow came ready to play and never trailed in the game.
Rachel Hodge standing her ground. And there is the first bucket of the night. Looking for that give and go. They found it. Under a minute to go.
The nice diagonal look and the give and go, just weren't able to connect.
Kelsey Haycook again carrying the offense.
Right. Again, they're pressing Sterling. Sterling's getting opportunities. They're just not making the most of it.
What a deep three.
Sterling's offense struggled throughout the first quarter and didn't score a field goal till 2 minutes into the second quarter.
Sanchez, and there's Sterling's first field goal. Crowd back into it a little bit. And if you leave her open like that, she's going to make it every time.
You can have that look. Make that look. They know where everybody is.
Kylie with the shot. Banks it off the glass.
Nice job away from the ball.
And to Point Pleasant's credit, they're shooting the lights out here in the early going.
Wow, very impressed there with Haycook. Long drives to the basket, so, you know, they're guarding her close, but they don't want to get those fouls right now.
Kylie with the three.
Man, get a stop here in a basket.
I don't think they were better than us, but I don't think we played to our best ability that we could have played.
So we weren't making shots in the first half, and it was just, it's like, what is happening right now? We're not, this is not us. We weren't finishing, we weren't making shots.
And they capitalized on every mistake that, you know, we made, and we dug ourselves into a hole early. And going into halftime, I think we were all kind of a little disappointed, I think is one of the words, because, you know, we knew we were giving it everything we had, and yet we still weren't, you know, coming up with anything. We weren't coming up with any shots. We weren't coming up with any loose balls and things like that. And we knew we were going to have to dig deeper. And I think at halftime in the locker room, we were just kind of like, this is it.
And it was really frustrating because, you know, the girls, again, to their credit, they listened. They followed the game plan. We knew where the shots were going to be. We knew where the openings were going to be. But as a team, we shot 0-for-10 in the first quarter. And to play as hard as we played and to play as well defensively as we played and to still be down 9-3, you're like, oh, man, this is, you knew it was going to be a battle.
Stop. And you see that 1-3-1 zone right there. Kylie going to drive, put up her shot, and connects. Ball almost stolen. Monica going to put it up, and it drops.
A forced pass, turns it over.
Sterling with a turnover, though.
Going into the fourth quarter.
And that's not going to help.
Now do it for the third quarter.
It's three right now.
Dish out to Kylie for the three.
Connects.
Kylie loses the ball, gets it back though. Monica going to drive. Yeah. She connects.
Sterling just swatting the ball away, not trying to get the rebound.
Time had finally run out on the Lady Knights season and the seniors' careers.
Played their hearts out. And they left it all out on the floor right here. Coach McDonald pulling everybody over. A lot of emotion involved right now. And they deservedly show. They're giving, everybody's giving them a standing ovation.
Do you like to see right here?
I was pretty upset that game. That was probably the only game of the season I cried, or probably the only 4 years of the season I cried. It was really sad to know that we didn't get it and that all our 4 years that we wanted to win a championship and how hard we worked, but it didn't come true.
As time starts to wind down, kind of everyone catches a glimpse of one another and we just see like that pain in their eyes, like this is really it and we have to let go of everyone.
Very deceptive. You look at her on film. As we look at Rachel Hodge, you know, what a great career she's had here. Obviously very disappointed. Of course, you talk about players coming up big. Didn't she came up huge in that Willingboro game.
It was our season, and we wanted that so bad. And just not to get it. We took the day off of school. We were hurt. We had a team party. We were trying to stay together as a team because that's what we do. That's what Sterling's been for 4 years, is one team, one family. And that game, you know, it just hurt us. We'll never forget it.
It's funny. You go from one of the, most exciting, most, happy times, like I said, leading up to the game, and you're coming down to the last seconds or the last few minutes in that game, and you realize, like, all right, we're not going to pull this off. We were kind of just thinking, like, we've worked this hard, and we came up short. And I at first we were thinking, like, I can't believe we lost it and everything, and then we have so much to be proud of, and it sucks, and we were really upset and everything, but we had to try and look at it like we've done everything we can. And tonight, the better team won. And, you know, we came up a little bit short, but this is where we wanted to be. We got the chance to play for what we wanted to. It stinks to come out on the other side. It hurts. I think the fans were chanting, like, we still love you. And it was just one of those really emotional times. I get emotional now talking about it, but I've had the best experience of my life here. And we went into the locker room, and that's exactly what we said. We just said, like, this has been an awesome run. Like, we couldn't have asked for anything more. We had so much fun, everything. And we just decided, I think it was Monica that said, like, you know, let's walk out of here together. And when we left the locker room, like, we all held hands and we walked out and just kind of said, like, all right, like, here we are, and, like, we're proud of what we did and we're going to hold our heads high and just, like, trying to say thank you to everybody and, you know, we appreciate it.
And I'm looking at the clock and I'm trying not to cry because I know all the girls are feeling the same way. And I turned to Tim as the buzzer was over and I remember saying, I don't know how I'm going to talk to them. I don't know what I'm going to say to them. And that was really hard. And he was like, you have to go in there and you have to be composed, which was a joke because it was just impossible. But that walk into the locker room was really hard because I didn't know what I was going to say. I knew I'd have trouble getting the words out. There are many tears. And he just kind of felt like an opportunity was missed. I wanted the icing on the cake. It has nothing to do with me. I'll be back there coaching next year. I'll be back for many, many years. But I wanted this particular group of girls just to have that fairy tale ending. I wanted it all, like, somebody's got to win a championship, you know, why not them? Why not after all the hard work that they had put in? And, you know, it was really hard to see that game, and I've been dreading it for a long time. And then, you know, went in the locker room and I just told them that I couldn't have been more proud and honored to be the coach of such a special group of girls. Hugs, tears. And then the coolest thing that I won't ever forget was when we were ready, like, nobody wanted to leave the locker room because it was safe in there, you know, everybody was upset. And so we walk out and I don't know how it started, but somebody said, I don't want to walk out. And then somebody said, I wish I could remember who, but somebody said, we all have to walk out and we're all going to walk out together. And everybody held hands and somebody grabbed my hand and we walked out and no one had left, like, everyone was still there and everyone was cheering for us and saying how proud they were of the girls. Just the fact that everybody stayed and, like, you knew, like, everybody was behind us and the community was behind us, and that was what meant a lot to me. And that was one of the things I felt the worst about losing, was like, I think the girls and myself wanted to win for everybody that had stuck with us all year, like all the guys that came and played with us all summer and all the teachers that came to everything and all the support we got, you know, and coming out of the locker room hand in hand and everybody's still, you know, there to cheer the girls up and tell them that it was okay, you know, will stick with me for a really long time.
The senior girls, I will miss them. They were a great group of girls to play with. I mean, I remember coming in my freshman year, I transferred, and they were all very welcoming, but being the type of person I am, I'm very sheltered unless I don't know you. And once I opened up, then that's when things started to progress. I mean, I knew Anissa, but Tanjay was the loud one. She became my best friend. Monica was quiet but deadly. Kylie was just the hype one and cheery. And Rachel Hyde was the cool, collective, silently funny one. And AK and Gab, they were all great. I mean, they made my experience here at Sterling better.
You just can't help but smile playing with all these girls and just everything we've been through on and off the court, in and out of basketball. It's just an amazing group of girls to work with. Like, I've never played with girls that make you feel the way they do. They make you feel good. They can just bring you out of any sadness that you've ever overcome.
Playing with them, it was great, on and off the court. We got to know each other as people. I think we formed a lot of strong friendships, almost kind of like sisters too, I think. We always had each other's back. I don't remember what year it was, but I think we played Hamilton. And one of the girls just went, I think she saw Kylie. She was walking past Kylie, and when she noticed it was her, she kind of, like, turned around and shoved her. And I just, like, grabbed Kylie and jumped in front of the girl, and then Kate grabbed me and, like, shoved me into the locker room. I thought that was fun. But that's, like, example of how we have each other's backs, because I wasn't letting that go down. She wasn't just going to push Kylie like that.
It felt good. It was great knowing that, like, I could be a captain, I was a leader, and I was the floor general, telling everyone what to do and the right thing to do. It's going to be really weird not playing with them. I'll miss them a lot.
It was family to me, so I wouldn't go if I had trouble at home. It was more than a game for me, and to have played with the girls I played with for 4 years and the seniors that left before me, it's been a complete and absolute privilege. And especially working with the tech crew, everyone I met through that, everyone who was there every game, teachers that came to every game, I was privileged. A lot of students don't get to say that they had a great supporting fans or great supporting teachers or even a principal that gets rounded up exactly in this seat every morning. with, you know, the mascot of the other team and a basketball, hitting them in the head and screaming go nice. There's not many people who can say that they've had a four-year basketball career like I have.
I guess it all starts being a Sterling Silver Knights fan back when my sisters played. You start to develop those feelings then. You can't wait to get to high school already. I think I was like 5, maybe. I started watching when I was a baby, but I don't remember a lot from then. I was just in the gym when I was just a little infant. I remember the summer, like, coming into, like, leading up to freshman year and just being like, I can't believe it's finally here. I'm so excited. And then starting freshman year was, like, so much fun with Monica and everybody. And we won some games, and that was the year we surprised people. I remember Kate saying, you know, freshman year you got lucky. And we had some of the best times. It was kind of just like getting used to it. Like, okay, the newspapers were talking to us. We weren't used to that. We didn't understand what that was all about. And then we go into sophomore year, and it's, you know, Kate called it growing pains. And we won some big games that year, and we lost some big games. And that was when we lost to Henn Township, I think, and it was a heartbreaker. And we were all just kind of like, you know, 2 years in a row, we've been right here. Like, the year before we were with Collingswood, now we're with Henn Township, and it was like, all right. And then we got ready, we worked hard for junior year, and we thought, you know, this is the year, this is the one. And it was so much fun. And then we come to play Camden, and it was an amazing game, one I'll never forget, obviously, in my life, because of that shot, which was awesome. One of the coolest experiences, again, and mostly because of the crowd and because of the team and just the way it happened. And I really thought we were going to pull that one out. Came up a little bit short. And then senior year was just, I don't really have a lot of words to describe senior year. It was amazing. It was everything that I could have expected and more. And like I said, we came up a little bit short, but I think you look back on our 4 years. I look back at mine, and I think that I've had the greatest time in my life. And people ask me, you know, are you excited for college and stuff? And I'll say, yeah, you know, I am excited for college. But I can't say enough about, like, my school. And I loved it here. I loved my team. 4 years were amazing. I had some of the best times of my life. And the school, the support, the pep rallies, everything, getting ready for games, people coming out to watch. Like I said, them chanting, you know, we love you. And them being at the Camden game junior year, just, like, things like that are the things that you'll never forget. And I think you can look back on what we did. I think we all do. And I can't say enough about Kate. We've had the experience that a lot of people don't get to have. And we've enjoyed every second of it. And I don't think we would, I mean, maybe we'd change some things if we could, but not really. I wouldn't change a thing about, you know, these past 4 years.
Looking back at this class, I will have nothing but fond memories for those girls. From the girls that started since they were freshmen to the girls that started off on the freshman team and worked their way up and never got a whole lot of playing time. They still, you know, everybody was dedicated to one cause. And we went through a lot of ups and downs and growing pains. I specifically remember meeting every one of them. I just feel like I watched them grow up, and I feel like the girls helped me grow up and helped me be a better coach. If I told those girls to paint their faces purple and run through a brick wall and we would win the game, they would have done whatever I told them to do. And they were such a pleasure. I know I'm going to stay in touch with them. And, you know, to see all of the 6 seniors that graduate are all going to college, you know, a lot of them are on scholarships, a lot of them are going to keep playing sports. We just couldn't be happier for a group of girls, and it was a blessing for me. And I will take all the things that I learned from them, and I learned from those big games, and I'm gonna use that for the future. And I'm gonna miss them a whole lot.
missed it. There you are. You're running for your life. You're a shooting star. All those years, no one knows just how hard you work. But now it shows that one shining moment you reached deep inside. In one shining moment you knew you were alive. Feel the beat of your heart, feel the wind in your face. It's more than a contest, it's more than a race. Did your best, 'cause inside you knew that one shining moment you reached for the sky. One shining